Today's video was made possible by Logitech G. If you're in the market for a new headset, keyboard, or mouse, visit the link in the description below. Use code PRESTIGE at checkout to get a discount off your entire order. Big thank you to Logitech G for sponsoring this video. Let's get started. A couple of days after the Season 1 Reloaded blog post where they outlined the Covert Exfil and weapon case feature coming to Warzone, the community blew up and Raven Software had no choice but to respond, and this is what they had to say. Over the last few days, we've seen your feedback about the Covert Exfil feature and have decided not to launch it in standard Battle Royale with Season 1 Reloaded next week. We believe that Covert Exfil and the gameplay loop it provides, paired with the weapons case, will make for an exciting addition to Warzone. That said, we'll instead launch both of these features in an upcoming dedicated mode. I don't even know where they could put it. Anyway, we're looking forward to the new challenges that these features will provide and to your continued feedback once the mode is available. So I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't really know what mode they could possibly do outside of an experimental playlist, just like multiplayer ended up getting at the beginning of this year. Unfortunately, we didn't see too much surrounding the experimental playlist in multiplayer, but I feel for Warzone it could be done a little bit differently, not only for testing updates to weapons, but also doing things like this, adding a Covert Exfil and the weapons case. When this was first announced, way back before it was even outlined on how it would work, I said right out, point blank, people are not going to want this. The Warzone community does not want change. It's purely based off of meta weapons, what's the current flavor of the week, and whether or not Raven can patch it fast enough for the next one to take its place. That's what the Warzone loop has been, and that's what it will always be. And there's no further proof of that than Warzone 2.0. That actually almost destroyed the entire Warzone community based off of the major sweeping changes that were made and the backtracking that the team did throughout the entire year of Modern Warfare 2. All of those new features that went untested that didn't click with the team on top of other things that were just super annoying from the previous version of Warzone that had already been taken care of but for some reason came back to rear its ugly head, I will never know why. There's been a lot of good updates with the newest iteration of Warzone, and I think people are pretty happy with it so far, but one of the biggest sticking points with the Covert Exfil was the condition that you actually win for leaving the fight, and that's pretty much what I saw. People seemed more upset that you were actually getting a win as opposed to staying and fighting it out and being the last squad alive like you're intended to in a battle royale. And, personally speaking, I don't think that the win was going to count as an overall win. I think it was going to count as a Covert Exfil win. They mentioned in the blog post that there would be a separate leaderboard ranking for Covert Exfils, so it would show separately apart from your normal wins. So I think people were blowing that out of proportion, but I kind of get where people are upset about that, because why would you and why should you be rewarded for leaving the fight early? The thing is, combined with the weapon cases, it would make for a pretty interesting gameplay loop. Like they mentioned in the blog post, the weapon cases, once picked up, will be marked for every single squad on the map. Everyone will know where you're at, similar to DMZ. You'll have to fight off multiple squads, or maybe some squads don't even want to go for you. They're going to spend their time building up their team to focus on the main win at the end, completely ignoring the Covert Exfils, completely ignoring the weapon cases, and that's definitely a way that people are going to play. But I definitely agree with people in the community. This is a big change, and it's a really big change to just make somewhere mid-season. Once again, going back to the idea that I mentioned earlier in this video, they definitely need an experimental playlist to test new features. At least throw it up for a week or two in an experimental playlist. If people like it and if they enjoy it, then keep it. If they think that it's a good way to bolster the speed in which a game could be completed, because I think that's one of the other big problems right now in Warzone, the games are taking a little bit too long. You can actually have this there to make those games go a little bit faster because there's going to be a giant hunt happening. And I did see some comments of people saying that they should add something like this to the Modern Warfare Zombies experience, but there's no PvP in Modern Warfare Zombies. If they were to do that, then I suppose they could definitely do something where you have a bunch of AI zombies chasing you or something like that, but it's not the same thing as DMZ. It's not the thrill and the rush that DMZ players are necessarily looking for. And there's already quite a bit of controversy surrounding Modern Warfare Zombies and people wanting PvP there, but it just wouldn't work based off of the structure of some of those missions and how the game is. I mean, I think there was a bug right before the holiday season where PvP was accidentally added to Modern Warfare Zombies and people were actually able to use ray guns and shit, kill everybody. It was just not a good time. It really wasn't. But this just goes to show that when there's a new mode that begins with awesome new features like DMZ, they let Infinity Ward cook with DMZ, and then they just kind of drop it, and they forget about it, and it just gets completely sunsetted when it didn't need to. It could have continued. They could have continued supporting DMZ. They could have continued it into MW3. They could have continued it into Treyarch's next title that's coming in 2024. I mean, it's just one of those modes that makes sense for a brand new community that flourished during that entire year where there was a lot of pain and despair in other modes like Warzone and multiplayer. DMZ was the shining example of what Infinity Ward's capable of doing with a brand new experience. And I really can't fault them for wanting to add some of those cool features that they added in that mode into Warzone. Because even I said it would kind of work in Warzone if you look at it that way. I think that people are just getting too hung up on the covert exfils and the win conditions. And, you know, the weapon case there is a really cool way to add more content for those that want to go for it alongside the champion's quest, which can also interrupt and disturb an entire match for players that are going for it. It just creates an entire chaotic thing. And I think the same thing can happen with these covert exfils and the weapon cases themselves. So let me know what you think down below in the comments section. Experimental playlists, they don't have to just stop at the features, right? They could also be used for weapon balancing. I think that would be another good thing. I think Raven should definitely invest in playtest servers, not just for their internal testing, but for select group of players that can sign up for it every single season. Maybe they just randomly select, I don't know, 50,000 players from an email list and they say, here you go, here's your access to the playtest server. We're going to be doing our playtest from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and we're going to be testing the covert exfils, and we're going to be testing the weapon cases, just as an example. And through those hours, those 50,000 people that were selected, they have a chance to experience it. They're not allowed to record it. They're not allowed to upload it. I'm sure NDAs, obviously that would cause a lot of leaks. But at the end of the day, at least real people are playing it. At least real people are giving their feedback. And not only that, they could do even in-house testing like they used to in the past. I remember when we went to Infinity Ward and Treyarch and Sledgehammer, during those times, sometimes we get access to early access things and we have a chance to test it and we would have a chance to give our feedback. If content creators, especially in the Warzone scene, are trusted, I don't really know how it works. Like if people are running tournaments or whatever and you guys trust them, I think that you should say, hey, he's the captain for the Warzone team. Maybe the captain for the Warzone team should go and check this out before anyone else has a chance to check it out. Give their feedback. Kind of like when pro players go and check out the game early and give their feedback for CDL-related things. It's the same idea. It's just done on a smaller scale. I said it in my last video, and I'll say it again. I'm curious what y'all think about the DMZ elements that are possibly coming to Warzone. I think that they could possibly work, but putting them in a separate playlist, I really don't know. At that point, why don't you just add them to Plunder? I mean, Plunder doesn't really get any updates. Plunder doesn't really get anything. You know, the last time Plunder got anything was when we were doing all those Easter eggs and bunker stuff back in Warzone 1.0. We don't get that stuff anymore, so throw it in there. Plunder players would probably be really happy to have it, something new to do, and with infinite respawns, it would create a super chaotic experience. So, anyway, let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you all on the next one. Peace.